Hi guys, for this video I'm using a crochet hook in size 5.5 millimeters and yarn in size 4 medium. I'll start by making a slip knot and then I will chain 62. Make sure that the chain is loose, you don't want it to be too tight. Now we'll make sure that our chain is not twisted. Then through the last chain from the hook, I'll make a slip stitch. And this is our foundation row. This will go over our hand. Now for row one, I'll chain 3. Now through that same chain, we need to make 5 double crochet, but this 3 chain already counts as 1, so we make 4 more. And now that we have 5 double crochet through this chain, through the next 30 chains, I'll make 1 double crochet through each chain. Now that we have made 30 double crochet, 1 double crochet through each chain, through this next chain I'll make 5 double crochet. This is our second increase. And now through the next 30 chains, I'll make 1 double crochet through each chain. Now that we are by the end of row 2, right here through this third chain, I'll make a slip stitch. So this completes row 1. This one here is a sample, but for this one here that I'm making, the original one, I'm changing colors for every row. Now for row 2, I'll chain 3. Now through the next double crochet, I'll make 1 double crochet. Now see here where we made this 5 double crochet, this third one right here is the center, so right through that third double crochet chain I'll make 5 double crochet, and that's the first increase for row 2. Now I'll make 1 double crochet through each chain until I reach this next 5 chain loop. Now that you reach this 5 double crochet right here through the next center, through the first 2 double crochets, I'll make 1 double crochet through each chain. Now through this next double crochet chain, I'll make 5 double crochet through that same chain. Now I'll continue making 1 double crochet through each chain until I reach the end of this row. Now that I'm at the end of row 2, the complete row 2 right here through this third chain, I'll make a slip stitch. This completes row 2. Now for the pattern, we repeat row 2. So we repeat row 2 until our work reaches our desired length. In my case here, I made 22 rows, but if you wanted longer than mine, then just make a few extra rows. And I'm going to make some tassels so that I use this paper towel tube and see if it works. Now take 4 of these strands, fold them in half, then right here through this chain, I insert a hook, then through this loop, pull through, then we just create a knot. Now we take 4 more strands. Like that, we fold them in half, then through the next chain, I insert a hook, then through this loop, pull through, then I'll make a knot like this. I repeat the same thing for every chain. This will fit sizes small through large, maybe even extra large, but I'm not sure. Here, if you want, you can just trim these ends so it can look more even, but it's not necessary. You can only tell the difference when you lay flat like this, but once you put it on, you can tell. If you don't want the tassels to be this thick, then don't put the tassel in each chain. Put it in every second chain. This is all for today, guys, and I'll see you next time with another video.